What's the magic, the timeless magic of Star Trek?
I think it came out at a time where there was a lot of issues to be dealt with in the world in terms of gender relations, race relations, you name it. It just came out at the right time, and Star Trek really has always been a message-oriented show, where each show has a hidden message to live life better. So there's always good in Star Trek. There's always something to help people out, and so that's why I think people gravitate towards it or are attracted to it.
For you, what were the distinguishing features of Voyager, and what do you think it added to the Star Trek unit?
First and foremost, a woman captain. That's huge. We got bomb threats when we first came out by a lot of people calling Paramount Studios saying they were going to blow us up because we dared to have a woman captain. So having a woman captain was probably what we added to it. A lot of people watch Voyager and they feel it harkens back to the original series because we were always out exploring. The original series, they're always out exploring, and we were always out exploring, not by choice because, you know, we were out in the Delta Quadrant, so we got to see unknown parts of the galaxy, of the universe that we'd never been to before. So there is that similarity with TOS, but the difference is really the first woman captain, which is, it's amazing. I mean, it's so empowering to have that character, especially for young female viewers.
What do you think Harry Kim brought to the series?
He was sort of the everyman of the show. People, you know, it was his first mission, it was his first everything, so people, when they watch the show, they watched it through the eyes of Harry, in a way.
Yeah.
The most interesting part of that for me, just the character development, the growth over the, you know, starting from being the most novice to then a seasoned ensign. I want to say a seasoned officer. Well, he is an officer, but he never got promoted, you know, which is kind of bizarre. I don't know why that ever happened. Yeah.
You'd like to see him get promoted because he deserved it, I think, a few times.
Well, here's the thing. You watch Tom Paris get demoted, remoted, promoted, and then you have to realize that at the beginning of the show, Tom Paris' character was a criminal. He wasn't even in Starfleet and he got a promotion. So if that's the case, then Ensign Kim should have been an admiral by the end of Voyager. Ensign Kim actually should have been promoted the first time he died. That should be a Starfleet regulation. If you die and come back to life, you're promoted immediately. So,
Admiral Kim, it has a ring to it.
It does.
And obviously fans have their favorite episodes, their favorite arcs. Looking back, are there any specific episodes that you're especially fond of yourself?
The 100th episode, Timeless, which is where the ship crashes into the ice planet. Ensign Kim has to basically go back in time and reverse what happened. That was probably the best Kim episode, yeah.
We're hopefully getting Star Trek Renegades. We're hoping there's going to be more Star Trek series in the future. Are you excited about that yourself? And is it something you'd want to be involved?
I actually turned down Renegades. So I was supposed to be in it, and the last second I kind of backed out of it. A lot of these fan series, it's good that they're out there, but at the same time, I don't know. I mean, I have very high standards in terms of what I like, you know, story-wise. And if it's not up to snuff, I'm sort of like not going to join. I'm not going to join the bandwagon, you know, just to join it. So, but I do think that there needs to be more Star Trek out there.
Mm-hmm. What do you think of the latest incarnations of the film franchise?
I like the first one. J.J. Abrams' first movie was brilliant. The casting and everything, the storyline was fabulous. The second one, the most recent one, I hated it. I actually tweeted a picture of myself before sitting in the movie theater, excited to see JJ's second movie, and by the end of the movie, I deleted the tweet. I felt like he was rushed. He rushed through it. The dialogue is rushed. Everything was rushed because he knew he was going to be directing Star Wars, which is his true love, right? And so he felt, let me just quickly get done with this Star Trek thing so I can move on to Star Wars. It was too cliche. I thought the casting of Benedict Cumberbatch, who is an amazing actor, I don't want people to think that I dislike him, but I don't think he's Khan. Khan, if you look at the background of the character of Khan, he's Sikh. Sikh is East Indian. Does Benedict Cumberbatch even look remotely East Indian? Hell no. Okay, so no, not believable. So everything about that second movie disappointed me. And it's unfortunate because I truly love the first film. I saw JJ's first film 14 times at the theater. I paid 14 times to see that movie. And I was not invited to the premiere. Nobody except for Leonard Nimoy was invited to the premiere because JJ has some weird thing where he doesn't want anyone from any prior Star Trek working on his Star Trek. So I really, like I said, I liked his first one. Fabulous. A+ on the grade. The second one, I would give a C- on that one. So.
I guess fans are going to want to know, where are they going to see you next? What are you working on yourself at the moment?
I've been laying low. I've been doing voiceover mostly. I just did I did Star Trek Online voiceover, where I rehashed the voice of Kim and Captain Kim and Ensign Kim, basically. So I got to do multiple voices, different eras, different ages. Like I said, in terms of on camera, I've stayed away from Hollywood for the last 10 years. It's been a long break. It's easier to be lazy. I'll say that much. But I've been a little bit, I've been wanting to get back into it. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. I just want to say thank you to all the fans out there for watching Voyager. And if you're a new fan and you get to the end of all the episodes and you feel sad, you can start them all again. That's the best thing about it.